This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is part four. We're going to be converting angles that are in degrees to degrees, minutes, and seconds. So we're going to be doing these two problems in this video. So here's our first problem. We have something in decimal form, 112.39 degrees, and we want to change this to degrees, minutes, and seconds. All right, so what does this mean, 112.39 degrees? It means the whole number part is 112 degrees, and then this is the part of the degree, 0.39 degrees. Now, I want to change this 0.39 degrees first to minutes. So we know that 1 degree is the same as 60 minutes. So it's like you could think of this minutes, I'm sorry, this degree symbol right here is like 1 degree. You can change it to 60 minutes by doing 0.39 times 60 minutes. So it's like I'm replacing the degree with 60 minutes. If you want to think about conversions, you could think of that, well, you have a degree, right? And then you're multiplying it by 60 minutes over 1 degree. All right, so in the end, you're just going to have 60 minutes here, okay? All right, so now we can go ahead and do this in the calculator. Keep in mind the whole number part of the degrees is going to continue just being 112, and then we just want to, you could do this in your calculator, 0.39 times 60, and that gives you 23.4 minutes. So if I were just asked to convert this to minutes, degrees in minutes, that would be my answer. I could write 112 degrees, 23.4 minutes, okay? So that's what I have so far. But I want to go all the way to seconds. So now I have to change the part of the minutes that is after the decimal point to seconds. So I know the whole number part for the minutes is 23 minutes, but now I have 0.4 minutes as well. So by the way, this is just in degrees and minutes so far. Okay, so how can I rewrite this 0.4 minutes in seconds? Well, each second is 60 seconds. I'm sorry, each minute is 60 seconds, yes. So I could change, again, this little minute symbol by multiplying by 60 seconds. So now I have 112 degrees plus, I still am going to have the 23 minutes, right? But now I've got 0.4 times 60. You could do that in your calculator or, you know, without a calculator, this is pretty easy. It's 24. 4/10 of 60 is 24. So I've got 23 seconds. But we don't write the answer with these plus signs. I'm putting the plus signs just so you can sort of concentrate on one piece at a time. So your final answer is 112 degrees, 23 minutes, and 24 seconds. If you do this correctly, you will definitely still have a whole number for the degrees and a whole number for the minutes. And for the seconds, you might have a decimal. For instance, if I multiplied by some number that, you know, some number times 60 that didn't give you a whole number of 24. And that's what our next problem is going to have. But you will definitely get the same whole number, right? We started out at 112 blah blah degrees, 112 plus something, right, a little bit extra. So your final answer is still going to have 112 degrees. So here's our next problem, and notice it's 0 degrees. So this is actually easier. We've got 0 degrees the whole way. I'm not even going to write that. I'm going to just change this 0.821 degrees. Sorry. I want to change that degree symbol to minutes. So I'm going to multiply by 60 minutes. So let's see, we're going to put in the calculator point 821 times 60, and I get 49.26 minutes. Okay, but I want to go all the way down to seconds. So I know the whole number part of the minutes is now 49 degrees, and I've got this much left over of minutes, 0.26 minutes. You know, I want to change that minutes to seconds. So I've got 49 minutes, and each minute is 60 seconds. So I could write that as 60 seconds, right? Multiply it by 60 seconds. And then we'll go ahead and do that multiplication, 0.26 times 60. And we get 15.6 seconds. So notice I wasn't able to get a whole number for the seconds, but that's as far as we go out. We don't go any further than seconds. So we only go to degrees, minutes, and seconds. So your seconds may still have a decimal point in it. But notice there's no rounding in either of these problems because you're always multiplying by a number. So it's when we divide it by 60 we might have to round. So what does this really mean? I'm trying to change 0.821 degree to degrees, minutes, and seconds. I already know it's 0 degrees. So my final answer is I still have 0 degrees, 49 minutes, and 15.6 seconds. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.